so the final piece of code that we want to talk about that actually contributes to the running of the model as opposed to the display and output of the model is the command that the Go procedure calls. So all of the stuff in the Go procedure, except for this word transact, are built-in parts of NetLogo, right? This transact command, though, is something that we're going to write, and it's going to be the basic function to control how the model actually operates. And the way the transact function works is it says to transact, give a dollar to another turtle. And so you're going to subtract a dollar from your own because you've taken a dollar from your income. And you're going to ask one of, and one of calls a random other member of a set, other turtles, and other says take this set and remove the calling agent from it. So take this set and remove me from it. And then take out one of those agents randomly. So one of the agents that's left from the collection of all turtles once you remove me from it. So choose a random other agent who is not me, right, from the set of all turtles, and increment their wealth by one, right? And so this is exactly the command that is described in the original setup. So if we had setup and go and transact, right, we would get the action you see up here within the world, right? Ignore the graphs, right? But you would see the action that's up here, right? And so that essentially, in a very simple level, is the simple economy model. And it, in fact, is the model that that among others Dragulescu and Yakovenko used in their 2000 paper, right? And it kind of has some interesting properties, and a lot of their work in that paper was actually describing those properties. And we're going to dive a little bit into that in the next subunit.